city that you from, nigga.
Metro, shut the fuck up and make some beats, Metro. Metro, shut your bitch ass up and make some beats, Metro. I can't stand Metro.
Hey, what's going on, everybody? Welcome back to yet another video. First of all, I want to start this off by saying thank you for all the support and the love that I received on my previous video. I did not expect that. I appreciate all the love. If this is your first video, you may want to go back and actually watch that video before you watch this one, because it's kind of a follow-up as to what is going on in this whole rigmarole we got going on in the rap world. All right, I'm not biased at all. I'm not biased, not one bit.
You ugly as fuck.
I respect Drake's position in the industry and what he's done musically, and truly his ability to capture moments, because that's what he does. You know, he loves to make he said it back when the Control verse dropped. He was like, you know, I like to make timeless music, and I'll give him that.
That verse was a moment to talk about. Are you listening to it now at this point in time? Okay. But like, if I asked you, for example, like, how does that verse start?
Miscellaneous minds, never explaining the minds. Devilish grin for my aliens to respond.
So, since my last video, Drake has decided to go ahead and respond. My mind all over the place. We're gonna react to The Heart Part 6 in his dumbass BBL Drizzy verse. I've personally never heard the BBL shit with Sexy Red, but I heard that he responded, and that honestly got me to want to make another video, because I was like, god damn, I was just gonna let it simmer down for a little bit and just chill. But he dropping responses using a Metro Boomin diss track beat, which has never been done in the history before. So by him hopping on that beat, he's kind of admitting that he's lost to it. I said it last video, but it's a little weird. I don't know, Drake, I think you've lost the plot.
All right. Pulitzer Prize winner is definitely spiraling. I got your fucking lines tapped, I swear that I'm dialed in. My Montreal connect, stand up, not far down. The ones that you getting your stories from, they all clowns. I am a war general, seasoned in preparation. My jacket is covered in metal.
Nigga, pause, nigga. Genuinely pause. It wouldn't stop. I don't know. He trying to control my shit right now. Back up, buddy. Two bars that I want you to remember. People that you got all your information from are all clowns. And the I am a war veteran, seasoned in preparation. Those are two very important bars that we most listen to. Okay. By the way, he's already discussed the allegations of. Really, what exactly? If I think about it, the New Ho King bar was created, and then people went back and looked up the New Ho King, which then it was a link to a robbery that he was in the past. And then the internet started saying that he was a snitch, because I don't remember at any time Kendrick flat out coming out saying the man was a snitch.
You waited for this moment, overcome with the desperation. We plotted for a weekend and we fed you the information.
Immediate contradiction. What are you talking about? You just said that the people that he's getting his information from are a bunch of clowns. So what are you doing? Are you talking to your clown enemies and being like, here's some information to go get Kendrick? Or are you talking to your clown friends and telling him to go talk to Kendrick? Because regardless, you kind of just called your homies and the people. You said we. So when it says you kind of talking about
a daughter that's 11 years old, I bet he takes it. We thought about giving a fake name or a destination, but you so thirsty, you not concerned with investigation. Instead, you in that Venice studio, it's a celebration. You got.
Listen, let that sit for a little bit. He said, you too overcome with desperation. Let that truly sit.
Gotta learn to fact check things and be less impatient. Fans are rejoicing, thinking this is my expiration. Even the picture you use, the jokes and the medication, the Maybach glove and the drug he uses for less inflation.
Master manipulator, you bit on a speculation. Did you just admit to being a master manipulator? Did you just admit to truly being like, yo, all of this concocted, I straight up made this shit for you, bro? Which ultimately kind of fuels Kendrick's point. Why are you going about your life like that, nigga? But you talk about fact checking things. Okay.
Dumb and reactive, nigga. I'm petty with dedication.
Dumb and reactive.
What about the bones we dug up in that excavation? And why isn't Whitney denying all of the allegations? Why is she following Dave Free and not Mr. Morale? You haven't seen the kids in 6 months. The distance is wild. Dave leaving heart emojis underneath pics of the child. Speak.
Aye. Let me know if I'm bugging. Nigga, not Summer Sonic Love, dog. Summer Walker. Summer Sonic Love. That shit kind of sound like it got a little jingle to it. Sounds a little crazy. After further evaluation. Pause on the play.
It's my
my Honda, still the truth. A nigga still gon' be a nigga. Emoji heart my family pictures. Two stepping away from rap.
He said, emoji heart my family pictures. The cover of The Heart Part 6 is Dave Free emoji hearting a family picture. So, this could be fuel for Drake's allegation, or this could be Drake going back, listening to
You ugly as fuck,
you out of pocket,
and then taking the emoji heart my family pictures and be like, oh, I know who did that, because he's kind of has the insight to it. I don't know. What do y'all think about that? Because I think there's a link in that. What'd he say?
Is she like the other than I'm trying to wink? Is she like furries then I'm in a mink? Psych. Blooded by horse and I think I'm in hell. I'm finna read that bitch pussy like braille. That shit was wet and it looked like a whale.
Hip-hop is such an interesting place. Honestly, it just gets better and better. I'll never hate on it, bro. Shout out to Yeet. Shout out to Lil Pump, Smoke Perp, all of that shit. Gotta love the ignorance. Just understand it and don't succumb to it.
Can anything with a child, let's get to that now. This Epstein angle was the shit I expected. TikTok videos you collected and dissected. Instead of being on some disdirect shit, you rather fucking grab your pen and misdirect shit.
That just pissed me off. The reason why it pissed me off, because the first thing that came to my mind is, you'd rather pick up a pen and misdirect shit. You make your whole career off of doing that, dog. You and Jay-Z have been doing the subtle back and forth. Like, you never just go at niggas, bro. The last time I heard you directly go at somebody was Megan Thee Stallion. You do this shit. Like, your shit is literally being like, I'm going to say something that could inquire this person, but I'm not going to actually say it, but I'm going to get the people talking so they think I said it, but I did say it, but I didn't say it, but I did say it. You expected an Epstein angle. Why? Because a compilation of TikTok videos? Okay, so put yourself in his shoes. Random day, he's scrolling through TikTok and finds a video about how Millie Bobby Brown is talking about her relationship as a 15, 16, however old she was, underage, talks about her relationship with him. And he uses that as evidence against you, but it's his fault for compiling it and trying to use it back to you. Oh, nigga, that shit's kind of weird, bro. You expected it because it's been an ongoing thing before Kendrick decided to even talk about you. When he was on his hiatus, he wasn't even talking about you. But you were doing your thing, which was, I don't know.
My mom came over today and I was like, Mother, I, wait a second. That's that one record where you say you got molested. Oh, fuck me, I just made the whole connection.
Cut the shit the fuck off.
What is it?
Bro, what is he doing?
I don't know, I really don't know.
I told you on the last video. There he goes with his fucking epiphanies. The epiphany that he will go on to make later, not the best. I just warn y'all right the fuck now, he fucked up. I need y'all to know that I just sat here and paused because I'm going to insert a clip. When he has epiphanies, we're all fucked. Because we have to now dissect some crazy conspiracy weird shit that don't make any sense. So you want to talk about your seasoned war vet and seasoned in preparation, compiling information. All right. So if that's the case, then you would understand that Mother Eyes Sober was not a song where Kendrick spoke about him being... You would understand that that was a song where he was recounting how his mother didn't accept him saying that he wasn't because of her past traumas that rubbed off on him in the form of continuously asking the question. He's like, nah, it didn't happen to me, but what is hurting me is the fact that you're so, like, adamant about asking me this, and you're adamant about not believing me when I tell you no, it didn't happen. That's what Mother Eyes Sober is about. Ah, fuck me, it makes sense. Yo ass listened to Mr. Morale and the Big Stepper and truly thought that you had every angle that you needed to come at this man, bro. He talks about his relationship issues. He talks about his fucking addiction. Last time I fucked a white bitch, I was 16 at the Palisades. Fumbled my grades. I traveled with the team. The Apache life centennial was like when Miss Baker screamed that dope boy. Mixed that we're in a race and entertain the scene. Happy just to be out the hood. What I knew listening to that fucking album would go towards something. I don't know why. I just remember music like that. He spoke about his addiction true innocence, alcohol, and the lust for women, and he spoke about it throughout his career. Swimming Pools is one of his most popular songs for a reason. You is one of his most polarizing songs for a reason. The video is a depiction of him getting fucked up. Like, that's been a known thing. So the point that I'm making on this tangent, the point that I'm making is that he claims to be a war veteran seasoned in preparation, but listen to a song and extracted the wrong information. It's kind of confirmation that you are dumb and reactive, my nigga.
This about to get so depressing.
For you, nigga. Go back and listen to Push Ups. This shit is just like, I gotta respond to this nigga, bro. This is about to get so depressed. Like, he's really, like, in the studio just, like, getting this off his chest. A story need to come out about how this motherfucker snuck behind his whole entire team's back and just dropped this shit. Because, bro, if your people heard this shit and still let you release it without proofing it and going and listening to Mother Eyes Sober, which is supposed to be the biggest bomb in this shit, like, yo, that was you denying the fucking, I didn't even go off about the whole fucking denial of the certified lover voice, certified, but you talking about, I'm too rich. Are you? This nigga R. Kelly did it on camera, got caught, and still got away. Just to get fucking caught in it again later in life with more compiled evidence. What are we talking about? Anyway, we seeing what's going on with the bad boys and shit right now. We see what's going on right now. No, you not, my nigga. What are you talking? That's no response to this shit.
I'm too rich for that.
What? Y'all the main perpetrators next to Pre.
I don't want to dish you anymore. This really got me second.
I don't want to listen to this anymore. May have to edit that out.
Touch my body by Mariah Carey, play, you probably start reflecting. I never been with no one underage, but now I understand why that's the angle that you.
Why does Mariah Carey catch a stray? Imagine to the motherfucker out there that genuinely experienced that trauma with that song attached to it. And then Drake just randomly brings it up. Why? We can talk about everything, dog. We can talk about actions that you've done. But when you start to talk about actions that were done to others and try to use it against them, what in?
Really mess with. Just for clarity, I feel disgusted. I'm too respected. If I was fucking young girls, I promise I'd have been arrested.
R. Kelly did that shit on camera, nigga. I know it's a different era. But don't get it twisted, nigga. Whatever it is, motherfuckers gonna find their way to get away with some shit if they got me like that.
Here we go, money talk.
Like if Dave really fucked your girl and got a prank and talk about breeding resentment.
Day Free got at least one B in the oven. Oh shit. Hold on, K-Dot.
This game,
bro, I don't give a fuck, bro. It's gonna go away after 2 weeks like every other game does, bro. Niggas don't give a fuck no more.
Dude, when I like, he ain't been through nothing. Day Free got at least one B in the oven. I'm tripping, I'm jigging my mental. I the big shot, wrist on cryotherapy. Soon as I press that button, nigga better get right, like the emblem's coming. Us two, when I like, he ain't been through nothing. Day Free got at least one B in the oven. I'm tripping, I'm jigging my mental.
Amazing, brother. Pop off only on occasions, brother.
I'm not gonna lie. This kind of adds to Drake's whole angle. I'm not even gonna hold you. Y'all have heard me talk shit about the man. So when I fucking am fair, and I'm playing the advocate, not of the devil, but of the truth. You know what I'm saying? You gotta see the duality. Day Free got at least one B in the oven. What does he mean by that? Does he mean he has $1 billion cooking up? Or is he saying Day Free got at least one B in the oven?
Nigga better get right, like the ambulance coming.
Call the ambulance. Tell him breathe, bro.
Got at least one B in the oven. I'm tripping, I'm jigging my mental.
And then he immediately crashes the fuck out.
Show my ass in, take out of class. I can multitask like Megan, brother.
This nigga dropped Not Like Us and Meet the Grams in the same week. Two perspectives. And he was showing his ass on both of them. Because it was some super villain shit on Meet the Grams. And it was some diabolical shit on Not Like Us. Because you got niggas doing the diddy bop to motherfucking They Not Like Up. Then you got niggas dissecting the fucking You and Turks popping perks, escorts and hit dessert. But he did the duality, dog. He did the duality, dog. Oh, also, shout out to Megan Thee Stallion. She graduated from college. You know what I'm saying? We praise black women over here. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, Kanye changed his life, but me, I'm still an old school Gemini.
Did he? Did Kanye change his life? Beautiful big titty, but they give them in just to fall like the sky, you know.
Bitch, two phones, but I only bring one in this bitch. One daughter, but they all my sons in this bitch. No ho,
one daughter, but they all my sons in this bitch. So it's like he's sonning the rap game, but he's talking about his daughter who is his latest child, but like they free got at least one B in the oven.
Only fucking with Whitney's, not Millie Bobby Brown's. I never
Who the fuck brought up Millie Bobby Brown in this whole entire beef?
I'm a fucking hitmaker, dawg, not a peacemaker.
R. Kelly was a hitmaker. I'm just saying, nigga. Step in the name of love.
Using bot comments, you may as well keep the paper. Shit you about to need for later. I give a fuck about your streaming data. You could drop 100 more records, I'll see you later.
Kendrick didn't even say nothing about his numbers. This nigga Drake just saw them and was like, man, fuck you. He can't believe that another motherfucker who's been popping just as long as him went away for about like 6, 7, 8. Like, he went like 5 years. It was 5 years. He went for 5 years without dropping an album, however long it was, and was still popping just as much as you because of his cultural impact, and then comes back, talks shits about you. You drop your diss track, which is a big response to his Euphoria track, right? Then he immediately follows that up with Meet the Grams, and you talking about, oh, you're buying views, you're buying comments, you're buying. What? You ain't the only nigga that got control of the internet, dog.
If you still bumping R. Kelly, you could thank the savior. Said if they deleted his music, then your music is going to a hypocrite. I don't understand.
Which is kind of interesting because I'm gonna get into this shit real quick. Long live X. It wasn't just R. Kelly that Kendrick was talking about. He was talking about music in general. One of those artists who was being affected also by that at the time was XXXTentacion. Take that as you will, but like this wasn't just him trying to come to the defense of R. Kelly or trying to come in the defense of like what he had to say. You know what I'm saying? But it's very interesting that like this kind of wraps back to someone else who also had a beef with you, that you never said anything back directly. You do your little indirect shit that you just try to get on Kendrick for doing.
Whitney, you can hit me if you need a favor. And when I say I hit your back, it's a lot safer.
We're in Drake's shoes now. I've been talking about getting Kendrick's shoes. We're in Drake's shoes. Drake's perspective. Whitney is an abuse victim, right? And this nigga Drake just tried to pick her up and said, I promise when I say I hit you back, it's a lot safer. You think she wants to hear some shit like that, nigga? As an abuse victim? Oh, I still got her listen to the fucking BBL shit.
I say, who, baby?
Go together.
It's Stern.
Nigga, we go together.
If she said, it's Stern. I love this song. I don't know what the fuck this is. Like, shout out to Sexy Red. I ain't got nothing to say bad about her. It's Stern. I fuck with Sexy. But like, this don't add shit to shit. This nigga really moved on to the summer. Crazy.
I changed a lot of girls' lives for real. They need a new body. They hitting me. Hey.
You changed their life, but did you change it for the good, bro? Let's really talk about it. Because realistically, yo, shout out to anybody that got body work done. But I hope you also did the mental work that goes along with getting body work. Because ultimately, if you feel as if you need to augment the body that was given to you, whether you feel like it was by God or it was your two parents laying in the bed fucking and creating you. All right, bet. You don't fuck with something and you want to change it by going to the doctors or going to a fucking surgeon or something like that. Do the mental work. But shout out to the women who have done the mental work and the physical work and continue to do the physical work. But yo, listen, to the women that's out there that's not doing really no work, but going to a fucking doctor's office where he works and laying under that fucking pen and getting your shit changed and then turning around and promoting it as if you worked that, you worked for that shit, you worked out for that ass. Shame on you, nigga. Don't do that shit to the young girls. They need true motherfucking representation, bro, because the augmentation is not true representation. So like, I can't get behind this because it's like, oh, I changed a lot of girls' life, but beautiful big titty butt naked women just don't fall out the sky, you know? Not all the fucking time, you know? Fine is fine, you know? He's lost the plot, bro. He said, we hate the women you fuck because they confuse themselves with real women. Scroll, there's another motherfucker doing the same shit with the same work from the same surgeon. That's why a nigga like Drake has a good rapport with the surgeon, because he's sending all of these girls in this loop. The same women that he's talking about he can't marry, the same women he's talking about are scandalous and he gotta fucking put sriracha in his fucking condoms for. Sexy Red is authentically 100% herself. You feel me? Even if she plays up the character of ratchetness, that is her. That is where she comes from. That is her fucking background, dog. So I can't say shit about it. The point that I'm getting at is he's saying he got a cool rapport with the surgeon that does BBLs, bro. Like, that's not... I'm not saying BBLs are a horrible thing. Because in the hands of a right person, it's fucking cool. There are a lot of botches. There are a lot of mentally scarred people who do physical augmentations and feel like it's going to heal what is within them. It's not, dog. And really, that's why I fuck with Mr. Morale and the Big Stepper, and why I continue to fuck with Kendrick as I grow older. Because I'm understanding that you have to create and evolve. These situations in life were created for you to evolve from, bro. You can either evolve negatively or positively. It comes down to that. So him coming out and admitting, I'm sensitive, I feel everything, I feel everybody, one man, he'll every on with that type shit, that resonates more than a nigga turning around being like, I search one name and end up seeing 20 things. Like, nigga, pick one. You're 36. No offense, bro. Do what you do. Nigga, if you want to live the bachelor life your whole life, you feel me? And head to Delilah with all of your ice, do it, nigga. Cool. But, like, fuck. I guess the point that I'm getting to right now, I'm realizing that why Kendrick putting his foot down to an artist who is just as big as him and continuously doing it, because Control was an attempt at that, but he continuously did it in this one. Like, he raised flags to a lot of shit. Like, he gave people feel to be like, to say more than just, I just don't like Drake. He gave people actual feel to do the research on and to dive into. Like, I don't like the fact that he's still rapping the same after 10 years. I don't like the fact that his fucking music hasn't matured, nor does it seem like he has. I don't like the fact that at one point I fucked with his music, but then I found out he had a fucking child that he was hiding and we're gonna use for an Adidas press run. Like, I didn't like, what the fuck? I don't like the fact that he's stealing other people's flows. Like, for so long, it was kind of just, he kept making hits, so it was really hard for you to keep up with the, I don't fuck with that nigga, I don't fuck with that nigga, I don't fuck with that nigga, because Kiki, do you love me? But then when Kendrick came out, Kendrick finally said something about it, it was like, oh shit, an artist who's been popping just as long as you is coming out with their opinion of you, but they also have a background of self-work. Like, their body, their work is the body of work. You feel me? Wait. Their mind is their body of works. In the way of, they evolve with the music. He goes away for 5 years, comes back, and is on some different shit. It's been like the same shit, just increasingly up in the ante, more and more and more and more. Is it Auntie or Annie? Annie, are you okay?
I swear, you ain't get your masters, but I still break breath. Yeah, you think I'm a bachelor girl, but I swear, you ain't get your masters, but I still breaking your.
Did he just diss her? Because to sit there and say that she didn't get her masters is kind of a. You didn't get your masters, but I'm breaking your back out in the masters. That's only beneficial for you, bro. I hope she gets her masters. What the fuck are we talking about? Man, shout out fucking Sexy Red getting her bag. That shit was bad, though. Dog, what the fuck? I don't know if I mentioned it, but I'm getting sick. So, like, that shit, like, doubly don't sit right with me. Like, what?
I rap with a Pyrex and a projects. I'm cracking a pot, I'm a prospect. I'm a pirate on a dock full of dope. I could dissect any rap.
My bad, y'all. That is a pleasant surprise from my childhood, bro. I remember the fucking Beats commercial that dropped with fucking him and Dr. Dre, bro. And I remember I was scoured the internet for this fucking song right here, bro. I could never find it. Like, bro, he couldn't get the verse, bro. He had to show up, bro. Ah, man, that's history right now. But no, I don't want to do it again. I don't know where to go from here. I really thought that the BBL song would give me a little sense of direction as to where I was going to lead this. But realistically, it just kind of pissed me off. Like, what the fuck is you doing, dog? But anyway, opinions, comments, let me know how you guys are feeling. I may update if somebody drops something. I don't know. I think he realized there's nothing he can do. There's nothing this man can do. I released the tape. The 888, if you guys are interested in finding a new artist that you may enjoy, I may be that motherfucker. I make music. I've been doing it for a very long time and I love doing it. So all links will be down in the description below. I don't even know how I'm gonna edit this yet. I mean, I know I'm gonna edit it, but like, I'm probably gonna do it the same format as last one. So all links to the instrumentals, to the fucking memes, all of that shit will be down in the description below. So everybody get their credit. You feel me? This is a community. It's not a community channel. This is my shit. But like, this is a community effort in a sense. You feel me? We all are on this globe together. So yeah, let's all create, entertain each other. But Drake, you're failing, dog. You lost the plot. Where do you feel? I personally feel like he lost the plot. But again, thank you guys for all the love showed on my video. I don't want to like draw this out super long, but I really want y'all motherfuckers to know that I'm thankful. So like, thank you, my nigga. Fuck. Like, yeah, like, dog, I've been doing YouTube for so long, and like to see that shit pop off, like, I was like, great day, man. You know, I can't let the views clog my mind. Nigga, I'm talking like this and I got 15,000 views, so you know how much this shit mean to me. Like, I'm over here like, I can't let 15,000 clog my mind, bro.
Oh my goodness, I can't take it anymore.
But I can't, like, you know what I'm saying? I gotta keep it going. But also, yeah, I don't know where the fuck I was going with that.